Good morrow, people of the internet, and welcome to Phoenix Wright, Ace Attorney. Last time, we did some court and we had something massive revealed. They fake evidence. My god, who knew? Anyway, let's carry on. I'm so sorry, Mr. Wright. Let me volume up. Volume! Here we go, volume. I'm sorry for what my sister said. Drastic crimes require drastic measures. That's just the way it is. We did what we had to, in order for him to get the verdict he deserved. I didn't know. I never knew that the SL9 incident was just another name for the Joe Darke killings. It's like everyone's heard about these killings but me. Lana wanted Darke convicted so badly, that's why she used me. That's why she used what happened to me. What do you mean, what happened to you? It's all there in the file. Joe Darke's last victim was prosecutor Neil Marshall. When he murdered Officer Marshall's brother, he left behind an incriminating piece of evidence. But what do you have to do with those killings, Anna? On the night prosecutor Neil Marshall was murdered, Joe Darke tried to kill me.
But what? He tried to kill you?
Officer Marshall's brother, Neil, was only trying to save me. So that means you... Yeah, I was a witness in the Joe Darke trial. I didn't see that one coming. It happened over 2 years ago. It was right about this time of year, too. It was a terrible thunderstorm that day, unusual for the season. I was alone in my sister's office. We were planning to eat dinner together once she finished her work. Then suddenly, this terrifying man came bursting into the office. Joe Darke. Seems like he was running from someone. He pulled out a knife and screamed at me. I didn't know what was going on. Just then, Prosecutor Marshall showed up. Jake Marshall's brother. Joe Darke tried to take me hostage. But before he could, Mr. Marshall tackled him. Then, what happened? I'll never forget it. Lightning struck and the lights went out. Suddenly, a bolt of lightning flashed outside the window, lighting up the office for an instant. What I saw then burned a permanent picture in my mind. I can still see it now. Permanent picture. I don't remember the moment when Darke stabbed Mr. Marshall. So, you weren't able to testify about that? No, I was only asked about when I was attacked. That must have been why Lana, why she made up the crime.
Made up? You mean... provided bogus evidence?
The prosecutor's office wanted the guilty verdict so badly. Lana forged the evidence and Mr. Edgeworth used it.
Edgeworth?
Yeah, but I'm sure he didn't know anything about it. He couldn't have known he was being given false evidence. Even so, that's when it all started. The rumors about Mr. Edgeworth, I mean. It's all my fault. If I could have just testified properly, none of this would have happened.
So it's true, even though he may not have known it. Edgeworth really was involved in falsifying evidence.
After that case ended, Lana was never the same. She became cold like she is today. She must not have been able to face up to what she did, especially not to Emma. What did you see in the instant that the crime occurs? Darke knocked down Mr. Marshall and raised his knife. Neil Marshall was stabbed right in front of this poor girl. I don't remember what happened after that. Apparently, I passed out. When I came to, Lana was cradling me in her arms. Poor Emma. You've been through so much. I couldn't bring myself to testify about that incident. I tried, but the words just wouldn't come out. I drew a picture, but it wasn't any good. 2 years ago, you must have been 14. That's understandable. Once it was all over, I made up my mind. I decided that when I grew up, I'd become a scientific investigator. I want to be able to fight crime with my testimonies. Find the evidence to make an airtight case. That way, Lana would never have to forge any.
I see. I think I'm finally starting to understand what makes Emma tick. But there's still something that bothers me about that crime. There's something that's puzzling me, Emma. What is it? You said you were in Lana's office at that time, right? That's right. Why then would a serial killer come running in there? Not only that, but he was being chased by a prosecutor? Oh, there's no mystery there. Joe Darke had been taken in for questioning that day. Taken in for questioning? You mean by the police? Of course. This happened at the police department. He tried to run away, halfway through the interview, and fled into my sister's office. But why did he run all the way over to your sister's office? Because the detective offices in the questioning room are right across from the elevator. Across from the elevator? But Lana was the chief prosecutor, wasn't she? No, no, silly. Didn't I tell you? 2 years ago, Lana was a detective. She was the best in the entire force. What? That's news to me. After the Joe Darke case, she was transferred to the prosecutor's office and made chief prosecutor. Lana used to be a detective? I'd better have another talk with her. To the detention center! February 24th, detention center, visitor's room. Lana, Mr. Wright, it seems I keep causing you trouble. Falsifying evidence. I didn't think you were the type. Criminals don't mind playing foul. Why should we? But Lana, if you're wrong, an innocent person might be found guilty. Believe me, I understand the risks. Lana, Emma told me about you. Oh? About how you were a detective 2 years ago. And how the SL9 incident was the reason for your transfer to the prosecutor's office. That's right. Could you fill me in on the details? Especially about that unusual change of jobs. I suppose you have a right to know, Mr. Wright. Talk. Today's trial. A lot of revelations were uncovered at the trial today. Not the least of which was the fact that this case is largely connected to another one 2 years ago. Evidence from that case was stolen. I expected as much. I know how obsessive Officer Marshall can be. That trial, it really wasn't fair, was it? I believed in you, Lana. I believed that no matter what happened, you'd always stick to the truth. It couldn't be helped, Emma. At that trial 2 years ago, I sold my soul. Well, all the drama aside, the fact of the matter is, at 5:15, there was no murder at the police department. Tell me it's not true, Lana. Why the what the witness, Mr. said? About you stabbing Mr. Goodman with a knife? Lana, I don't understand. Why won't you tell us? Emma, this doesn't involve just me. I don't think I've ever seen Lana look so phased before. It's true, I was a member of the police force 2 years ago. She was amazing! They still talk about all the cases she and Chief Gant cracked together. Chief Gant? Then he was the vice head of criminal affairs, but he still worked the crime scenes. Damon Gant. He was everything I aspired to be. They were the best team ever. They solved crimes before the reports could even be filed. And Marie idolizes her big sister. But now you're chief prosecutor. What happened? I always planned on becoming a prosecutor. The reason I became a detective was to gain experience investigating crime scenes, so you could later use that experience in court. Gant's help in the SL9 case was critical in its resolution. After that, he became chief of police and arranged my transfer to the prosecutor's office. Maybe I should ask more about this investigation of theirs 2 years ago. Darke investigation. 2 years ago, I was second in command of the detectives investigating Darke. Second in command? That means the chief detective was no doubt Damon Gant. Yes. Detective Gant and I shared the same office and the same investigations. We even had the same office. We led a team of the best detectives on the force. Detective Goodman, whose case it was, Jake Marshall and Angel Starr. It was the first time Marshall worked for his brother. He was quite gung-ho. Without a doubt, Joe Darke was the serial killer. We asked him to come in for questioning. We were desperate for evidence. That was when the last murder took place. When he tried to murder Emma. Prosecutor Marshall was trying to save me from Dark. You see, the first person who happened upon the scene of the crime was me. Now you tell us. Detective Gann and Prosecutor Marshall were the ones questioning Dark that day. The investigation was at its final stages when Dark must have panicked. He waited until Gann and Marshall let their guards down, then he fled the room. From there, he ran straight to the office shared by Detective Gann and myself. That's where he found me. So, you were the first person to run into the scene, Lana? It appears so. I was filling some papers while Gann and Marshall were questioning Dark. When I returned to my office, I saw three bodies on the floor and smelled blood. Three bodies? Prosecutor Marshall, the victim Emma, who had passed out, and the suspect, Joe Dark. During the struggle, it seemed Mr. Marshall struck a final blow before he died. Joe Dark had incurred a minor concussion and lay unconscious. What did you do? To be honest, I panicked. I picked up Emma, carried her out of the room, and just held her. Can't blame her, after all. Her system must have gone through. After that, I placed Dark under immediate arrest. Let me get this straight. You were all involved in the SL9 incident. That's right. Quite a coincidence, hmm? I don't buy it. What are you saying? There's no way everyone involved with this trial was also involved in that incident. Just by chance. But that case was solved 2 years ago. At least one person went to extremes because they didn't believe it was truly solved. Officer Marshall. Yes, his actions came as a surprise to me as well. Ever since his brother died, he's changed completely. I guess he wasn't convinced with the ruling against Joe Dark. Life doesn't end with the closing of a case. Everyone has to live the rest of their lives with their memories. That case just might not be over yet. Emma was assaulted by Dark in the police department, right? Yes, in the offices that Damon Gant and I shared. The office that Gant now occupies by himself, the chief's office. Maybe we should have a look at the chief's office, the site of the final SL9 murder. Alright, but before that, I'm gonna go get a drink, because I'm really thirsty. I'm back. I just had a drink. Yeah, let's check the walkthrough for what to do next. Criminal Affairs. No. The police department entrance, where we should go. I'm tired. Nom. I don't see Detective Gumshoe anywhere. Things seem kinda quiet around here today. You're right. The head of the department seems to be the same, though. Why don't we go look for some other people to talk to? Right. We can come back here later. His department entrance. Alright, 24, police department entrance. Oh, Mr. Marshall!
I never thought things turn out this way when I woke up this morning. Coop said, Dunno says, you never know what life will lead you to, eh, Bambina? I should've known my luck had run out when old Billy dried up this morning.
Billy?
Not these pet cactus. Say, where are you headed? Just over to the prosecutor's office for a little interrogation. It's a voluntary appearance, but we all know I won't be coming back. Sorry, but you can't go in the evidence room to take part in that.
But, Mr. Marshall, why did you do it?
Why do prosecutors head west? Prospectors, maybe. That said, if ever there was a case I needed to know the truth about, it was that one.
Before you turn yourself in, Mr. Marshall, would you mind telling us exactly what happened?
Looks like I won't be getting a steak lunch today.
The walkthrough says, just talk to him.
Just keep talking to him. Dark Star, I'm gonna eat a Nutella sandwich that I have here.
Nom.
Something was fishy about that trial from the beginning.
wasn't just me either.
No, the detective's that, so...
What do you mean, fishy?
Some of the facts we know were inconsistent with the evidence we found.
For example, the murder weapon.
The murder weapon? You mean that switchblade knife? The broken tip?
That was your dark's, alright. But in the initial autopsy report, a question was raised.
A question?
The blade of the knife is not a perfect match for the wound to sustain. What does that mean?
Well, what does that mean?
In the report, that was finally submitted, that possibility had been erased.
Could the facts have been concealed with forged evidence?
In that case, that bad scars in all of us.
The scars that the SL9 incident left behind.
Let's get a marshal.
I got the looks, but he got the brains. He was one of the best prosecutors around. I had just made detective when it went down. It was our first case together.
How old was he? Your brother?
He was 27 at the time. He was awarded the highest honor that third day.
The highest honor? You don't mean...
King of Prosecutors.
Not that again.
What are you looking at me like that for? That's an honor for a prosecutor.
Mr. Marshall must have really been close with his brother. The day the SL9 incident took place, that wasn't the same day as...
That's right. It was the day of the evidence transfer.
Interesting.
It was drizzling that morning, but by nightfall there was much thunder. I can't believe 2 years have gone by already. I tried to steal the evidence so the case wouldn't die.
Apparently someone tried to stop you. Detective Goodman was murdered. And the evidence locker was empty.
There was something going on behind the scenes in that case. We all knew that later. Every detective involved in that investigation, save one, was taken care of. The star was fired and I was demoted and boxed away in a tiny room.
What about Detective Goodman?
If they did something to him, too, the commissioners would get suspicious.
Oh, wait, wrong words.
No, they were careful enough not to be too obvious. They?
Who are you talking about?
Get up, Sabanina. I mean, Damon Gant and Lana Sky.
Gant and Sky.
Chief Detective Damon Gant is second in command, Lana Sky. Posting on the force who hadn't heard of the duo. The case was the biggest step in both their careers. After that case ended, Lana transferred to the...
prosecutor's office, right? I just like that voice.
Yeah, Damon Gant, the chief of police, arranged for that to happen. She's never been the same since she left. Everyone who knew her said so. Chief Prosecutor Scar was totally different when she was a detective.
Now that she mentions it, now that he mentions it, Emma said something like that too.
Tell me, what happened to my sister?
Sorry, Bambina, but her secret is too well guarded. I never found out.
Not a secret. It all started 2 years ago.
So there you have it. That's my story. Did you enjoy it, partner?
It was certainly enlightening.
There's one thing for sure I found out in court today. That boy, Edgeworth, isn't my enemy. He was the one who used false about evidence to get a guilty verdict. And someone else was the one who gave him that evidence and planned everything. That someone is Damon Gant. Don't believe me? Well, I don't blame you. I won't even be a patrolman after today. Too bad I won't be around to work with you. And you become a real scientific investigator. Adios, Bambina.
Whoa.
Edgy.
Eef. Criminal Affairs Department. February 24th, Police Department, Criminal Affairs. Place is just pretty empty, but today it's deserted.
That must mean everyone's been solving crimes.
Oh, if you're looking for the others, they're all in your conference room. Thanks. Wow, he actually talked to us. With the chief prosecutor saying what she did and the decision on what to do, but Mr. Edgeworth not to mention our statement in the media tomorrow's trial. There's more chaos going on than Thanksgiving and Christmas put together.
I think festive is the word usually used for those. Sir, we'd like to have a look around Chief Gant's office.
Let's head across the hall to the other building and take the elevator up to the top floor.
Really? You mean it's okay for us to go in there?
I mean, we aren't police officers or anything. Hey, you're right, you can't go in there, it's off limits.
Now I see where Detective Gumshoe gets his unique charm. Well, what are we waiting for? Let's head to the chief's office.
Chief's office.
Forever 4. Police Department, Chief's Office.
Whoa, where am I?
In the Chief's Office. In the Chief's Office, silly.
At least, that's what it said on the door. Check out that pipe organ. That's real, isn't it?
Hey, I used to take organ lessons in kindergarten. They used to call me Little Miss Bach.
I thought I was a genius until they tried teaching me.
Never could remember where C was.
Hmm.
Oh, it's you two,
Chief Gant. You put the paper he was reading on his desk.
So, Mr. Wright, have you been swimming lately?
No, I haven't. I've been kind of busy lately.
I can appreciate that. I've had my hands full too with Mr. Marshall's misconduct and Lana's provocative statement.
Provocative statement? Oh, you mean about the forged evidence?
2 years have passed since that incident. My, how time flies. See that picture on the wall over there? That's a picture of Lana, Neil, and me.
So this is Mr. Marshall's brother, Prosecutor Neil Marshall.
We took it to commemorate our work together.
Something's not right with this picture. I can't quite seem to put my finger on it, though. Gant team picture added to the court record.
Anyway, I'd like to reminisce all day, but there are matters that need my attention. I'm going to lock up here, so let's go out together.
Oh, but in this office, it was a crime scene 2 years ago, wasn't it?
That case has long since been over. There's no need to investigate it anymore.
All the same, we'd still like to have a look around.
Perhaps you didn't hear me. I said there's no need to investigate it anymore. No, Harbin, get out. I have a meeting to attend.
Can we break in? These fiends aren't gonna break in? Looks like we won't. Well, aren't we? Seems that case isn't over with yet, after all.
What do you mean?
Chief Gant denied our request to search the crime scene. That means there must be a reason he doesn't want us looking around in there.
You mean, like a clue?
It's got to be a way to find... we can get inside the chief's office.
But what does the walkthrough say?
Criminal Affairs Department 3. Okay. Oh, God. February 24th, Police Department. Criminal Affairs.
Hey, pal.
This is Gumshoe. Were you in a meeting?
I was, just taking a breather. My feet hurt.
From sitting so long in the meeting?
Actually, I had to serve everyone coffee.
Looks like Detective Gumshoe still out of the loop.
Say, have either of you seen Mr. Edgeworth?
Edgeworth? No. Why do you ask?
He's under fire from both the police department and the prosecutor's office. It's almost like the battle's between you two in court.
That sounds serious. Is it because of what my sister said?
That's basically what it all boils down to. That falsified evidence 2 years ago? Now Mr. Edgeworth was the one has the whole world after his blood.
Yikes. Okay. Edgeworth crisis. But why would Edgeworth be blamed? It's not like he knew the evidence was forged. Honest guy's guilty party here, isn't she?
Regardless, the prosecutor is responsible for the evidence he presents in court. Not only that, but as you know, there have been a lot of rumors going around about Mr. Edgeworth. Those who don't like him haven't been able to do anything because of his amazing talent as a prosecutor. But now, with this...
Are there really so many people who hate him?
In our world, only those with talent rise to the top. Mr. Edgeworth not only had that, but he's young. There's no better recipe I know for making enemies.
Hey, Dick! Keep up the good work!
Yes, sir!
Let's go out for lunch again sometime. My treat!
Yes, sir!
You gotta take my back to that joint sometime. Okay, Dick?
Yes, sir!
Seems you don't have any problem with enemies.
Yeah, well, I'm careful not to stick out. Anyway, I'm a bit worried about it. Under all this pressure, I'm afraid Mr. Edgeworth just might crack. Actually, I took a look at their file earlier while the coffee was brewing.
He seems genuinely concerned for Edgeworth. Well, did you find out anything?
The only evidence Darke left behind was during his final attack.
His final attack? You mean...
when he killed Prosecutor Marshall who was trying to protect some girl.
Me. Did Seth Gumshoe never realize Emma was the girl?
That's when he left the most incriminating evidence of all.
Well, what was it?
Let's see. I think it had something to do with the murder weapon. Oh, I forget. Look, it's all written somewhere in here, okay?
His powers of recollection never fail to impress. Maybe we should show him the murder weapon. It might jog his memory. Darke's crimes.
Joe Darke was 42 at the time of the crime. He was just your run-of-the-mill businessman.
A businessman? What made him take to serial killing?
One day on his way home from work, he hit someone with his car.
With his car? So, it was an accident?
An accident, yes, but transformed into an animal.
An animal?
He killed a man that witnessed that incident. Then he killed a lady who saw the second. A kid walked by just then, so we killed him too. Then he was buried with bodies. A Darke came on the scene, and he was killed as well. Finally, he turned himself in.
Seems he was pretty careful, this animal.
Of course, this is all conjecture. There wasn't a single shred of evidence.
So he turned himself in...
Yes, but in the middle of his questioning, he fled and murdered his final victim. Prosecutor Marshall. That crime was witnessed by someone too, but unfortunately, he was arrested on the spot. It's a good thing that the last witness wasn't killed.
I lost a witness. Must mean Emma. Present the murder weapon.
The world!
About this.
Hey, don't tell me that.
There's a tag attached to it with the label SL9 incident on it. I believe this would be the broken murder weapon you were speaking of.
What are you doing with that? Ever since that case was closed, that knife's been locked away in a locker.
On the date Detective Boomer was murdered, this suddenly disappeared from the locker. And was found in Mr. Edgeworth's car muffler.
That's it. Now I remember what that incriminating piece of evidence was. When you showed me that knife, it all came back to me.
Well, what is it, Detective? Quick, before you forget again.
Come on, tell us that. What is it?
This knife. It was Joe Darke's, wasn't it?
That's right. We traced it back to the store he bought it at and had his fingerprints on it, too.
But no one actually witnessed him using it to murder anyone, right?
That's where his luck ran out. When you take a good look at the knife, you'll see it's broken.
You don't have to take a good look at it to notice that.
Yeah, well, anyway... Take a guess where the broken tip of the blade of the knife was found. That's what did him in.
Where was it?
The victim, Neil Marshall, was carrying it inside his own body. It was found deep inside the stab wound.
Did it match Darke's knife?
You bet. Down to the last fiber.
That's pretty conclusive.
Neil's autopsy report added to the court record. Switchblade knife added to the court record.
Well, there you have it in a nutshell. That's all I know.
Can I ask you one more thing?
What is it? If it's money you need, you should ask Chief Gant.
It's not money, but it does concern the Chief. His office is a crime scene, right? It's where Prosecutor Neil Marshall was murdered.
The Chief's out now, and his office is locked, but we'd like to have a look around if that's okay.
Well, any detective's ID card can unlock the door.
What? Really?
But if I let a civilian in there, I'd be charged with breach of trust.
Breach of trust?
Simply put, I'd be canned.
Oh.
Sorry, pal. I don't plan on getting fired because of you.
How about this ID card? It was Detective Goodman's.
That won't work either. The data was deleted the day he died.
Oh.
So in other words, Yamcha was our only chance of getting into that office.
I wonder if there's something we could show him that would make him change his mind.
Any detective's ID case as a good as idea was deleted today, so you need to find something. Prosecutor Underground Parking Lot. Okay. I know where I'm going. I know where I'm going now. I'm gonna take a bite of my sandwich. Nom. Noms.
Row 24, Prosecutor's Office, Underground Parking Lot.
No one's here today. Not even Miss Star.
Everyone's probably busy looking into what exactly went down in the evidence room.
That must be where the detectives are. We proved in court today that no one was murdered in the evidence room at 5:15 PM on the day of the crime.
Oh god, didn't mean to put that.
Yeah, I thought we were finally making some headway in our case.
But instead, it looks like we just ended up making Lana look even more guilty.
Hang in there, Lana.
Gotta find all the answers by tomorrow. Alright. High Prosecutor's Office.
February 24th, High Prosecutor's Office. Room 1202. I wonder if Edgeworth is back yet.
There he is. It looks like he's writing something.
Huh? What are you doing here?
He sure was quick to throw that paper in the floor.
Tough day in court, huh?
I've had to live the past 2 years with rumors flying around. What's another allegation to me?
Cheer up, Mr. Edgeworth. I'm rooting for you.
That's Edgeworth for you.
Always trying to hide his real feelings. So, what do you want? Unlike some people, I don't have all day.
Forge evidence.
There's no excuse for what I've done. 2 years ago, I used false evidence to obtain a guilty verdict. If it all breaks down to, and nothing I do can erase that fact.
But you didn't know, did you? The evidence was falsified.
The police department and the prosecutor's office share a bond of trust. If that bond is broken, we stand to lose everything. The police department's error is my error. The responsibility as the prosecutor isn't in charge. The fact remains the same, no matter what excuse I might have.
Mr. Edgeworth,
I take pride in my work. So tell me why. Why has it all come to this?
Even Edgeworth can't keep this kind of emotion bottled up. Tomorrow's trial.
Are you up for the trial tomorrow?
First last year's trial, and now this one. It seems all you do is worry about me. To be honest, you're getting on my nerves.
But Mr. Edgeworth, you can't just walk out on the trial.
Tomorrow's the last day. It's too late to change prosecutors. I'll bet that's what my superiors are banking on. I never thought that the case would come back to haunt me like this.
What do you mean?
That list of evidence, it seems so too short. Most lists run twice as long.
It's only half as long as most lists. That is odd.
After Neil Marshall was murdered, I became prosecutor for that case. I may not have been part of the investigation, but at the time, there was only one thing on my mind. I'd use the evidence I was given to prove the suspect guilty. Say we just saw a picture taken around that time. We just saw a picture. Something seems strange about it. Day of the Crim. Could you tell us again about what happened that day? The day Detective Gummins was murdered? You were participating in a ceremony at the station, right? I've never cared for ceremonies, but I had to attend that one.
Because you were awarded this?
Those receiving awards can't exactly skip out on the ceremony. I finished up at the office in the morning, and drove over to the police department.
You finished up at the office?
Yes, just odds and ends. Clerical stuff. I didn't plan on returning to the office that day. It is until I was asked to take something back.
Take something back?
This.
Well, yeah, Chief Gunn asked you to hold on to that, didn't he?
Yes, it was a piece of evidence in a case that was closed half a year ago. He asked me to bring it back to the prosecutor's office.
And that's the story we heard yesterday.
So you came back to the prosecutor's office because the chief asked you to?
That's right. God, we have so much evidence. This picture was hanging on the wall in Chief Gant's office.
Prosecutor Neil Marshall. He had just started making a name for himself. Looks like this was taken when he received the King of Prosecutors trophy.
Speaking of that, there's something that bothers me.
Yes?
The trophy Mr. Marshall is holding, it's a little different than yours.
Yes, you're right. I remember now.
Remember what?
That was the official prosecutor trophy used until that time. There's a story behind it.
A story?
Alright, we're back.
Sounds interesting. Would you mind telling it to us?
It's simple, really. Contradiction. That's what the award's based on.
Talk.
This award originates from an ancient Chinese tale. In Chinese, the word contradiction is written with two characters. The first means halberd, and the second one means shield. Have you heard this story?
Me?
Sure. Everyone knows that. Why don't you tell it, though?
For Emma's sake.
Very well. Long ago, in the Kingdom of Chu, there was an arms merchant. One day, he presented the king with two items. The first was a halberd he claimed he could slice through any shield or armor. The second was a shield he claimed could withstand any weapon.
Wait a minute.
Objection!
Those claims contradict each other!
Very perceptive, but then again, you've heard this story before, right?
Anyway, as you mentioned, the very description of these items discredited both. When the king pointed this out, the merchant was left speechless. And thus, the Chinese word for contradiction was born.
Oh, I see. So the chipped shield and broken knife symbolize...
Precisely so. They symbolize the merchant's items. The ancient tale ends with the merchant at a loss for words. But it's in our nature to pursue matters to their conclusion, even if it results in something as ugly as this.
Wow. Thanks, Mr. Edgeworth. I learned something new today.
That's funny.
When that's so, then why are you only given a shield?
We'll have to ask Chief Gaunt. 2 years ago, he had this halberd part of the ward abolished.
Chief Gaunt.
Game Prosecutor Shover updated in the court record.
Where to next then? Walkthrough?
Go back to the underground parking lot.
Okay.
Back here. February 24th, prosecutor's office. Underground parking lot.
Excuse me. Would I leave you care for a quarter pound of roast beef?
Sir! I guess she's out of lunches.
You certainly are the curious sort, aren't you? Kind of like the first person who stuck a cow's nipple to discover milk. Still, I never thought you'd go digging up that case from 2 years ago.
Everyone in the show is involved in the SL9 incident.
Not only that, but the matter it cut on the very day the evidence from that case was due for transferal. It can't all be attributed to mere coincidence.
Aren't you forgetting something? You know, that little scene I happened to witness?
The instant Lana stabbed the detective gunman with a knife.
No matter how much of the past you dig up, it won't change what I saw. Most beef is meant to be savored when eaten.
The star's hatred towards Lana. It all dates back to 2 years ago.
Joe Dark, that's a name I'll not soon forget. We trailed him for half a year. Oh, the pressure. Still, I don't think I was ever more alive than I was then. Those days were steamier than a bowl of hot gravy. Poor old Jake Marshall, though. He must have been going through hell.
You mean, because of his brother's death?
They were close, those two. After Neil died, something took over Jake. He became obsessed. Seeing Jake like that made her all the more desperate.
Huh?
Lana Sky.
My sister?
The best of the best were put on the SL9 case. Of course, they were led by that legendary duo.
Lana and Chief Gunn. Oh, wrong voice.
That legendary pair is the reason we were able to keep up our investigation. And that's why we're so shocked over how it turned out.
I mean, with the forging of evidence.
Don't get me wrong, Joe Dark got what he deserved. Still, it was obvious the evidence produced in court was being manipulated. Items our team never found would suddenly appear, while other items were kept secret.
You didn't have proof anything illegal was done.
I'm proof enough of what happened. After that case, all of us save Goodman were relieved of our duties. Mostly, without even so much as an explanation, when Lana Sky transferred to the prosecutor's office and became chief prosecutor.
Lana always wanted to be a prosecutor.
Nothing's quite as simple as it appears.
Huh?
Lana Sky was merely being used as a pawn. That's my take on the matter.
He's being used?
Damon Gant and Lana Sky. 2 years ago, Gant was chief detective and Lana second in command. They were the best. They solved all kinds of cases together, didn't they? Damon Gant's magnetism in particular was almost unreal.
His magnetism?
By that I mean his ability to attract evidence. He produced the most incredible evidence in the cases he handled.
Incredible evidence? You mean...
Oh yes, there were rumors about him even back then. No one dared confront him though.
I take it he's talking about forged evidence.
Back then, everyone looked up to Lana. All the detectives wanted to be like her.
Really?
Oh yes, myself included. I was a fool, really. She hated anything crooked and always watched out for the other detectives. That's why she was so concerned for Jake.
Mr. Marshall.
When Jake's brother was murdered, she left as if she had lost her own brother. If it wasn't for her, I don't think Jake would ever have recovered from the shock. That's what it takes.
That's what makes it all the more infuriating.
Miss Star. That's why I'll never be able to forgive her. Why did she have to turn so cold after that?
Being used. Lana transferred to the prosecutor's office 2 years ago, didn't she?
Yes, thanks to Chief Gant's powerful influence. Chief... That's right. Having solved the SL9 case, his position as chief was secured. There was only one thing left for him to control, and no one could stand in his way. The prosecutor's office.
What? You mean that's why Lana was transferred?
If he could control the chief prosecutor, he can control the prosecutor's office. That must have been his goal all along.
But how could he control Lana?
I don't know, but one thing's for sure. Ever since that case ended, she's never been the same. It's only logical to conclude. There must have been a reason for her change.
At last. I'm finally getting close to the bottom of this ugly mess. Thank you, Miss Dahl.
You listen to me, rookie. It takes more than just ingredients to create fine cuisine. I hope you turn out to be a better chief chef than I've been.
Okay. Next. Criminal Affairs. Okay. Move. his department entrance. What do I present to him? Present Edward's letter. Wait, was I supposed to get a letter of resignation? Okay. Wait, we need to go back to Edgeworth. Back to Edgeworth. Underground parking lot. Nom. High prosecutor's office. Examine. That. Wonder what he was writing for.
Come on, Mr. Wright. Let's take a look.
Are you crazy? Edward's sitting right there.
Just distract him. I'll check it out.
Hey, Edward. Is that Detective Gumshoe? Out the window there? Oh no, he's falling to the ground! Hold on. First, let me see what the girl is doing crawling under around my feet. He didn't even look.
What? Letter of...
If you can't read, I'll read it for you. It says, letter of resignation.
Resignation? Edward, you don't mean...
I'm tired, Mr. Wright. I feel as if something inside me has died.
But Mr. Edward, none of it is your fault.
I know the path I've walked. You don't need to tell me. And the path I've walked hasn't been a just one. I can't forgive myself for what I've done. And no one else should forgive me either. Uh-oh. I think he's serious.
Mr. Wright, please, you have to do something.
It's a letter of resignation. I wonder if I can use it for anything. Letter of resignation in pocket.
Edward Ben will quit. He's the best prosecutor in the world.
Right now. I mean... Nom. Okay. Now we go to police department. Criminal affairs. February 24th, police department, criminal affairs.
Oh, hey, you're back.
You still there?
I gotta make 150 copies of these files. Brewing coffee, copying files, I'm turning into a regular DJ.
You mean a DJ? You're a DJ as well? If I'm not mistaken, I think he means desk jockey.
Oh, that DJ.
I got Mario Kart persistency, but my answer's still no. I'm not letting you in, Chief Officer, period. It'd be my neck on the line.
My office is the last crime scene in the SL9 incident. I have to take a look at that.
There's got to be something we can do to make Detective Gumshoe change his mind.
Letter of resignation? Shablooey?
What's this crumpled up piece of paper? No way! Mr. Edgeworth can't be serious!
Is he ever not serious?
I can't believe they pushed him to this far.
Mr. Edgeworth really feels responsible.
At first, I thought he was cold as ice, but now I know different. He trusted us detectives to provide him with sound evidence, but we betrayed him.
Detective...
That's it. I've made up my mind.
But...
Here, take my ID card.
We can't do that. If someone found out...
They wouldn't let you off the hook with another lost item report.
Look at me. It's no secret I'm already out of the loop. After all, I'm friends with Mr. Edgeworth. Depending on how this case turns out, I may already be as good as the Terminator.
What?
So at least let me do this, for Mr. Edgeworth's sake.
Alright, Detective. Thank you. Gumshoe ID tucked swiftly into your pocket. Back to Chief Gant. Chief's office. February 24, Police Department. Chief's office. There you go.
Here it goes, Mr. Wright. Click! Open Sesame. If anyone finds us now, Detective Gumshoe's a goner.
That happens, I'm counting on you to bail me out.
Yee! Sorry, I thought you were a ghost.
I didn't even know you could slap a ghost.
Ah, Detective Gumshoe!
What
are you doing sneaking up on us like that?
I wasn't sneaking. I was just worried something might go wrong. So I came too.
You're here? Then what's the point in giving us your ID card? Oh, Gumshoe's ID card in pocket.
Hey, don't do that to my card. I hardly ever get a chance to come in here, so I figured I'd have a look around myself. Besides, we're all in this together now.
You really do want to get fired, don't you?
Not if we're lucky. Come on, let's see what we can find out.
I've got a bad feeling about this. Hang, that's a good line. Police Department Chief's Office. Examine this, Chief Gun something for you. Chief's Office. Okay, talk to Gumshoe. That desk on the other side of the room, was that your sister's? Yeah, that's where I was waiting for Lana on that day 2 years ago. Is anyone using it now?
No, sir. This is entirely Chief Gant's office now. He practices a strict policy of preserving the crime scene.
That's a strange reason to leave it there.
He leaves it as a warning to everyone else. He wants us to always be alert. He told us himself at our New Year's party. Of course, he was pretty intoxicated at the time.
I see. So, ever since Lana left, no one ever touches that desk?
No one except Chief Gant and the cleaning lady who's in each here each morning.
Still, 2 years have passed since that incident. Can't possibly any clues remaining.
Can I ask you something?
Oh, sure.
You came here to look around, right? Because it's one of the SL9 crime scenes. I mean, that's your only reason for coming here, isn't it?
Why do you ask?
You don't think... Nah, you wouldn't be. No. No, there's no way. Never mind, don't worry about it.
Okay, now let's look around a bit more.
Hey, hold on! Not so fast, buddy.
Huh? What is it?
When someone tells you don't worry about it, it's supposed to be start bothering you, pal. You don't just go around like that.
Oh, sorry, this guy started to get on my nerves.
Okay, so
what's bothering you?
You don't think... Chief Gant might be a suspect, do you?
What? Yeah, Mr. Wright. What do we think of him? Chief Gant. So it's finally come to this. What do I think of him? Perhaps it's best I don't divulge my feelings.
Yeah. There he goes, ignoring me again.
Okay. Examine the safe behind Gant's desk. You have a choice to input number at the bottom screen, you'll put a keypad or phone. Okay. Okay. Examine. It's a safe. Examine. This is safe, isn't it?
Safe. That word is right with intrigue.
Okay, if you say so. It looks like the code needs to be in and this panel's opening. 7-digit number. I think I might just know what it is. Input number.
Do you know what it is?
I have a hunch.
Oh, I know. You want to try my birthday. It's...
No. I have a better idea. Here goes nothing. 7-7-7-7-7-7-7. Code confirmed, access granted. Bingo. What number did you enter?
Whose birthday was that, pal?
777-7777. The final ID card number on that record.
What?
The number of the mysterious executive officer who entered the room that day.
You mean 777-7777? That ID number?
I think you're 1-7 shy this time.
That can only be one thing. That's Chief Gant's ID number.
Say, anyone care to look inside? What's inside, Phoenix?
Is there any money in there? How much does he have stashed away?
Look, it's
a shard from a broken cup.
Someone looks familiar. Where have I seen this before? There's something else in here, too. This? It looks like a piece of leather cloth. This is a handwritten, isn't it?
Hey, I saw someone wearing a shirt like that once. You think the chief made up the design?
I don't think so.
Oh, well, it was just a thought.
Is that it? Is that all that was in the safe? Apparently so. It's empty now.
A piece of cloth with a handprint on it. And a broken shard from a cup.
They look like pieces of evidence.
But unless you can prove they have something to do with this case, I'm afraid I can't just let you take them. After all, pal, it's my neck on the line here.
Right. Now I have to prove their relevancy to get them.
None of these two items related to the SL9 incident.
Come on. I've got to be something we can show the detective.
Brew, I have a feeling, but...
Yeah, present the jar. Okay. Present the jar. Where is it? There.
Detective Gumshoe, could you have another look at this jar?
All of us put that back together. Oh, those were the days.
It's kind of early to be nostalgic.
Wasn't this sharp piece of evidence from that case?
That's right. One of the shards from the SL9 is sticker on it.
Doesn't this ring any bells? You know, that fragment we just found?
You mean this one? That was in the safe?
Yeah, that one. That was in the safe.
Now that you mention it, it's ringing a lot of bells. Let's see if it fits.
Assembled fragment. Here, let me see that shard. I'll take a crack at this.
Go ahead, pal. Show us what a rookie can do.
Mr. Wright, here's some glue.
If I can piece this together again, it'll prove Chief Gunn was knowingly hiding evidence. Here goes. Rotate to the left once. Left. Combine. No, other left. There we go.
There! It fits like a charm!
That of course means Chief Gunn willingly and knowingly hid a piece of evidence in the safe.
In other words, he concealed a piece of evidence from the SL9 incident.
But...
Hey guys, get a load of this!
What is it?
This piece you just attached is different from the others.
A reddish line on it.
A reddish line?
That's blood.
Don't get it. Why would Chief Gant hide this in his safe?
I'll say which our data has been updated. Okay, and also present that fingerprinting set.
Detective Gumshoe, I'd like you to have a look at this.
Hey, I know what that is. So you want to take some fingerprints?
That's a great idea, Detective.
Alright, go to town. Sheesh.
What are you doing? Why are you sticking out your hand like that?
Go ahead, take my fingerprints.
It's not your fingerprints you want to take.
Huh? Come on, this isn't time
for jokes. I'm talking about the cloth we found in the safe.
Oh, I knew that. The one with the handprint on it, right? Sheesh. Where's your sense of humor?
Okay, Mr. Wright, let's check for prints. Look at the powder on the cloth. Unless they've been absorbed into the prints, blow the rest away.
What are you, my mom? I don't have to be told a million times. Alright, let's get this over with. Examine.
Just go for all of it.
Yeah, it just works by speaking. I'm just gonna... Hello, my name is James. I run a YouTube channel on the... There we go. I give it my best shot.
The kind of result won't be any good at matching prints, will it? But it does look like we'll get cleaner for from this print. Here. Try a different finger, then.
Oh, let's go for the middle one. That seems to be the clearest. Just clicking.
Ah! Ooh! Ooh! Ooh!
Really? There's more? That looks pretty clear to me, pal.
Ooh!
There we go. It's not Gantz. Is it Lana's? Oh, it might be Lana's. Oh. No matches found. It's not Lana's then. No, that doesn't match. It looks like we're out of clues this time. Yeah, but it was inside Chief's safe. Right, along with that shard. So that means it's got to have something to do with that incident. Well, that happened right here in this room. Dude, it's flipped! It's the exact same thing, but it's flipped. No, it's not. I'm an idiot. Just check the fingerprints of everyone who was in here that day.
There, I see it. There's a high power of working. You just gotta have faith. Is it Detective Goodman's?
No. Jake Marshall? No. Emma's? That's Emma's.
Passing complete. Match found.
No. How can this be? What are Emma's fingerprints doing here? Hey, you found a match? Whose fingerprints were they?
Huh? It seems the prints are too old. They aren't clear enough to make get a match.
Oh, that's too bad. I thought they'd be Dark's prints.
Psst! Hey, you over there. What's going on here? What are the kids' prints doing inside the Chief's safe?
Don't ask me!
Let's just keep this information from Emma for now. Here, maybe you should hold on to this.
Shrivelcloth folded and added to the court record.
Now what, game? Walkthrough? Examine the Gantz desk the first time you come in here, you hear something green for- okay. Okay. Examine Gantz desk. Well, look at the size of the Chief Gantz desk! Speaking of that, when we were here earlier...
Oh, it's you!
Chief Gantz! On that paper he was reading in his desk. I wonder what he was reading.
This looks like a list of evidence. Using a case.
A list of evidence?
In most cases, the list runs twice as long as this.
Hey, look at the case name!
Huh? SL9 incident. I wonder what this is doing here.
Hold on, detective, what did you just say?
I said, I wonder what...
No, about the evidence lists. Normally they're twice as long?
That's right. At least there wasn't a lot of evidence.
A half-sized list of evidence.
That list of evidence, it seems too short. Most lists run twice as long.
What would the other half of the list be doing here? I knew it! The Chief must be hiding something about that case.
It would appear so. Evidence list added to the court record.
Well, was I any help?
Of course! Thanks to your ID card, we were able to get some hard evidence.
No, that's not very kind, is it? In other words, if it wasn't for his ID card, it would have been useless. Isn't that right, you and the coach?
Chief Gantz!
We didn't think you'd be back so soon.
Fortunately, I'm a man who believes in signs. As I was walking to my meeting, I happened to look out a window and saw a stray dog run right into a pole. Just then, I thought of a certain detective.
Do you mean me, sir?
Now then, I'm afraid I'm going to have to ask you all to leave.
Yes, sir. Sorry.
Oh, you and the coat.
Me, sir.
Drop off your ID card on the way out. You won't be needing it anymore.
But sir... Now get out. Yes, sir.
Be on our way too, then.
Wait,
You, the one with the spiky hair. Don't go yet.
Me, sir?
I'd like a word with you.
But, sir, I'm not a licensed scientific investigator yet.
You with the spiky hair, you're free to go.
Mr. Wright!
Look, pal, I've told you once, I'll tell you 1,000 times. The chief office is off limits. But no, you just had to go sneaking in there like that, didn't you?
I thought you said you didn't care anymore if you got fired.
Yeah, but if I knew I'd be like this, I never would have said it.
Now that I've seen the evidence Chief Gaunt was hiding in his office, I think I'm finally starting to get the picture. It's hard to believe anyone could keep quiet about all this time.
Anyway, you listen to me, pal? I'm gonna try smoothing things over with Chief Gaunt again. Later, pal.
After that, I heard from Emma. She said the police want to ask her some questions, so she'll be busy for the rest of the day. The Row 24, Detention Center, Visitor's Room. I see, so the chief asked Emma to come in for questioning.
It's no use thinking about it. Tomorrow's the final day in the court. I'm committed to doing everything I can to defend you, which is why I'm here.
But I've already told you all I can.
What you've told me over these past couple of days is absolutely nothing, not a single useful thing.
Really? I believe I did mention something quite important. Something I told you right at the beginning. I said that I was the one who stabbed Detective Goodman. You know, I think I finally figured it out.
Who it was you're hiding behind those words.
Mia did a good job mentoring you. I'm rather jealous. It seems Edgeworth was right.
Edgeworth?
Once you're convinced, you know something. No one can persuade you otherwise. Thick-headed is just the term you used, I believe.
Now's my chance to get her to tell me the rest of the story.
Keeping quiet.
I had to admit, I was born a little perplexed at first.
You insisted you did it, yet there was no incriminating evidence. That's when it hit me. It's not that you were unwilling to tell the truth. It's that you're incapable of doing so because of a certain individual.
What an intriguing notion. A certain individual, you say. So you think I'm protecting this person?
Protecting? No, I think afraid of is more like it.
If I'm not mistaken, the person in question may have persuaded you to silence. For argument's sake, Mr. Wright, who may I ask this person you're speaking of? The one I'm supposedly so frightened of? What is this person's name?
Damon Gant, I'd imagine.
Yeah.
Well, Miss Sky?
Mr. Wright, you're addressing the chief prosecutor. You not forget your place.
I take it she's still not ready to spill the beans.
My apologies. Could you please tell me a bit more about the circumstances? We were partners until 2 years ago. I respected him as a detective.
Assuming he is respectable, then tell me something. Why would he try to hide his crimes?
His crimes?
Both of you and Edgeworth will be brought before a board of inquiry what you did. Specifically, hiding and forging evidence.
Of course, these are serious offenses.
Why is it that, though, that Chief Gant's name was never mentioned?
Chief Gant?
Edgeworth didn't know the truth behind the forgery. The only party who could have possibly... The only party who could have possibly investigated that evidence
was... that a spelling mistake? Me. I had access because I was second in command of that investigation.
Yes, you, but also one other, Damon Gant.
You intend to accuse Chief Gant, you'll need more than just words. Show me proof that Gant's falsified evidence in that case.
Present the evidence list, or the unstable jar.
I think the unstable jar is more the thing.
I just found this in a safe in Chief Gant's office. This jar piece, and this strip of cloth.
Do you know what these are?
They're pieces of evidence from the SL9 incident.
The person concealing evidence was none other than Chief Gant himself.
Now tell me, why are you taking all the blame for him?
Touché, Mr. Wright. It's as you surmise, I cannot disobey the chief's orders, even if it means being found guilty for murder.
Why not?
Come now, Mr. Wright, you can't possibly expect me to be able to tell you that.
3 days ago. I had no choice but to cooperate.
In the matter of Detective Goodman.
Or perhaps I should say, following orders. Yes, that's more accurate than cooperate. Although, I can't tell you the details. I can say that I was given an order that day.
I need you to dispose of Bruce Goodman's body.
I'll find it inside the trunk of Miles Edgeworth's car. Just as I suspected. Despite what everyone believes, you are not the one who murdered Detective Goodman.
Correct. I was trying to take the body out of Edgeworth's car. The truck was broken. I discovered the murder weapon while inspecting the body.
The murder weapon? You mean Edgeworth's knife?
No. When I found the body, this was the knife stuck in it.
Knife from the SL9, isn't it? Serial killer Joe Dark's knife.
I couldn't just leave that knife in him, so I took it out and stabbed him with another knife.
That would be Edgeworth's knife.
That's right.
Even though
he was already dead, my hands were shaking at the thought of stabbing him. That's why I ended up cutting my hand.
That is the reason for the bandage on your right hand?
Yes. Seems that I got blood on the victim's shoes as well.
And then...
she saw me just as I plunged the knife in.
Miss Star. Why did you need to hide Dark's knife so badly?
It took a lot of work to finally close the Darke case 2 years ago. It was over with. I didn't ever want it to be open again. My intent was to prevent that, by whatever means possible.
So, you hid Darke's knife? The weapon used to stab the detective was evidence in Joe Dark's...
If word got out, which it would, the reporters would have, would have a field day with that.
So you wrapped the knife in your scarf and hid it? In Edgeworth's exhaust pipe.
Right, then I called my sister to tell her what had happened, and I asked her to hide the knife that was inside my muffler. You ask Emma? I didn't want anyone on the force to know about this.
That would explain why Emma is so confident about Lana's innocence.
Speaking of phone calls, I had a bad feeling about the one of them that day.
A bad feeling?
The truth is, after I received those orders from Chief Gant, the first thing I did was make a phone call.
A phone call to Patrolman Jake Marshall.
To Marshall? Why on earth would you call him? The lead investigator from the SL9 incident had been murdered. I wanted that fact to be kept hidden, and I needed help. He was the only other person I could trust. Or at least I thought I could trust him at the time. However, it seems that after I spoke to him, he went off on an escapade of his own.
Oh, you mean...
not wanting the case to die, he decided to take things into his own hands.
He disguised himself as Officer Goodman and tried to steal the evidence.
He had already stolen the ID card, but it seems he still hadn't made up his mind to break into the evidence room. After my phone call, any remaining doubts he had must have disappeared.
So the phone call calls the incident in the evidence room.
I'm afraid that's all I can tell you.
But, Lana...
you've earned my respect, Mr. Wright, both as a defense attorney and an investigator. Now please, don't pursue this any further in court tomorrow.
Tomorrow's trial is only one way to drive off Lana's demons. I've got to get the bomb on everything. Detective Goodman's real murderer.
What went down in the chief's office 2 years ago?
To be continued.
Oh, it's over.
Oh, it's over.
Yeah, I want to save.
Whew. That was a long one, guys.
Oh, God. Next time, on Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney. We're heading back into the court for what I imagine to be the last time. I think there's about 2 episodes left of this. See ya.